Hi there, and welcome to this lecture on process flow diagrams, equipment summary tables. My name is Marina Miletic. In this lecture, we'll examine the rest of the information that should be provided in an equipment summary table for compressors, turbines, and pumps. Some of this information has to do with the physical properties of the stream, and some of it is related to the equipment itself. Important information that should be in any compressor, turbine, or pump equipment summary table is the flow rate of the process fluid going through the equipment and its density. If you're using simulation software, both of these are provided for you on the stream table in Chemcad or Aspen. Next is the shaft power, and since this can be a confusing concept, let's take a moment to look at what this means. Shaft power is the power required to run the compressor or pump, or it's the power generated from the turbine. Compressors and pumps are actually two components. The compressor or pump itself, which is where the process fluid flows and is pressurized, and what is called the drive. In lots of cases, the drive is an electric motor, like in this representation, but it can also be a turbine or engine. The drive creates motion, which moves the shaft, which runs the compressor or pump. The drive is responsible for creating motion, and without it, no work would be done on the fluid. It's important to know that both the compressor or pump, as well as the drive, each have an efficiency. The compressor or pump has a shaft efficiency, and the motor has a drive efficiency. These are both important in calculating the shaft power, which is the theoretical power divided by the shaft efficiency times the drive efficiency. The theoretical power is the power required to run this piece of equipment, assuming both the pump or compressor and the drive are 100% efficient. This denominator, which is the combination of shaft and drive efficiency, is considered the overall efficiency for the piece of equipment. While Chemcad and Aspen do provide you with the theoretical power number, they will not calculate the shaft power for you. The reasoning behind this is that you must estimate the efficiency of the compressor or pump and the drive because it can vary widely based on design specifications. You can estimate these efficiencies by looking at pump, turbine, and compressor efficiency tables in a fluids book, or you can use an estimate provided in a design book. Once you've estimated the shaft and drive efficiencies, you can calculate overall efficiency, which then gives us shaft power. Notice that C103 has a negative shaft power because this is a turbine and not a compressor. Energy is removed from the fluid instead of being added to it, so the sign is negative. Next is the overall efficiency, which for pumps and compressors is the shaft efficiency times the drive efficiency. Something important to keep in mind is that turbines do not have drives because their job is to extract energy from the fluid. What this means is that for turbines by themselves, the overall efficiency is equal to just the efficiency of the turbine. If this turbine were attached to a compressor or pump, we could calculate an overall efficiency which combined the efficiency of both units. But if the turbine is by itself, we can only estimate the efficiency of that unit. The last section of this table features a list of stream properties, including inlet and outlet temperature and pressure, and vapor fraction of the stream. These values are provided in the stream tables in Chemcad or Aspen. You might question the redundancy of providing this information on an equipment summary table when this can be found on a stream table. This information is very useful for helping select the correct type of equipment and materials of construction. When this information is listed, it's easier to see the range of temperatures and pressures the equipment will be subjected to, and this can be useful when someone needs to speak to a supplier about purchasing or replacing this equipment, or verifying that the equipment type and material were selected properly. This information is also useful for daily operation when engineers and operators need to quickly determine the expected conditions of a specific piece of equipment. This concludes the discussion of compressor, turbine, and pump equipment summary tables.